this is going up. I can't hold nothing back, I'ma hold you up. I can't fit all my fantasies. Always talk to myself, cause it's only us. Always be giving my mind, don't know who to trust. I've been rolling my time for the Uzi. Trying to ride on my side, I get choosy. I don't know, never lose me. Ain't easy, hopping at the beginning. All my wishes came true like the genie. Wish all my money coming blue when they finish. All shit, you in the finish. See you in a minute, see you in a minute. I see you in a minute.
Bounce pass from Hill. And did the crew. Oh, and the buzzer beater's good. And give him credit. Good awareness of the time remaining.
And to me, the way you end quarters impacts how you end the game. It can go.
Giannis Antetokounmpo, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for the Milwaukee Bucks. It's been an excellent game for him offensively. He's got 21 points and counting. And we'll be back with you shortly. Gordon Hayward.
Our relationship started when I was in high school. He came to my morning workouts and really recruited me to Butler and was kind of the first guy that I think believed in me that I could make it to the next level.
And I'm sure, Greg, that relationship played a big role in Hayward deciding to join the Boston Celtics.
And not just a connection, but a respect. Hayward now a veteran in this league, while Stevens has moved into the conversation for one of the better young coaches in our league.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And for the Bucks here, they've been putting a show on, guys.
The offense firing on all cylinders. They dominated that first period.
That's exactly the start you want. You take complete command. Now you've got to maintain that focus.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court for the Bucks. Ilyasova at the four, with Lopez at the five. Then there's Hill, then there's Kyle Korver, and it's Connaughton in at the two spot. Or as the Sun players now in their second seasons, you can tell just how big the jump is between that first year and their second year in the league.
I think, Kevin, it's probably the single biggest growth opportunity. One of the things that happens is the game slows down for second-year players. Very rarely do you see a guy take a step backwards. They're comfortable, they're more confident, and they know what to expect.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, if you were going to lose Kyrie Irving, why not replace him with Kemba Walker? The Celtics brought Walker in from Charlotte last offseason, and it looks like he's going to pay off big time in Boston. The Celtics didn't exactly do what they wanted the last couple of years, but with Walker and Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum and a hopefully healthy Gordon Hayward, the Celtics aren't exactly going to be in the lottery anytime soon either.
Well, you're right on that, D.A. They're still stocked, and we love Walker. He'll, I think, mix well with this team. Thank you. Walker with a clean look from outside off the mark.
Boy, he won't miss many from that spot. The defense gets lucky there.
The Bucks working the ball around. Lopez passes to Bledsoe. Hayward grabs the board.
Well, we didn't see the same kind of control we're used to seeing from him. This guy is usually a tremendous finisher.
And Kenner throws it down.
And they are very comfortable running their offense through Walker. And you can see why. Drops a sick dime right there. That pass was right on the money.
Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
At the end of the day, though, it's 2 points. Don't hang your heads. Let's get refocused and play with more patience.
He can be a forgotten man in their offense sometimes, but the D still has to keep an eye on him.
And the Celtics making a change here. Tatum's checked in. Last game for the Celtics, they pick up the win against the Knicks in New York.
And guys, they walked into the arena with a certain kind of swagger, and we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
And what surprised me was how easy they made it look. It seemed like they got something out of every possession.
Oh, that's a golden opportunity to finish on the break, and he blows it.
It was right there for him. He'd love to have that one back. That was was embarrassing.
Yeah, they've gotten into a nice flow this quarter.
Well, guys, you talk about players coming in and with a huge impact. Jason Tatum showed he was more than ready to be an NBA star.
Where do you see a player as polished and as impactful as Tatum? Step right in to be one of the top players on a top team with Boston. Fits their system perfectly, and really the sky is the limit for that young man.
Pass to Matthews, and here is Lopez. And it's denied.
Encouraging to see Cantor trying harder on the defensive end. There's height. There's ability to block shots. Go to work, Ennis.
You talk about players that have transformed their bodies in the NBA. How about Gordon Hayward? Has added muscle every year while maintaining that speed and agility.
The first one falls. You know, Greg, when he came into the league, Hayward looked so young. You almost don't recognize him now.
I mean, the suit of armor from his time in the weight room and the hair looking sharp to match.
Robert Williams is checked in for Boston. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Antetokounmpo's checked in to the middle. It's tipped. And pushing it up, here's Boston. Walker's running, and slam dunk by Tatum.
Well, if he gets near the cup, Jason Tatum will leave no doubt. Woo-hoo!
And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
Yet another bucket in close. That's how he's earning his point today.
Celtics trail by 11. Walker with it. 23 points for him the last game against the Knicks in New York. Hayward can't hit.
Perfectly played defensively there. He made that a very difficult look.
Here's Giannis. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's going to go on Gordon Hayward.
And really, the ceiling for Antetokounmpo is limitless. I mean, he has the potential to be a Hall of Famer one day.
He's off on the first. And the Celtics rebounding well this summer. From the loss of Kyrie Irving and Al Horford, Kemba Walker possibly a better fit for this team.
And with their young core, understandable that they didn't want to extend Horford out to age 37. A revamped roster, but I think they remain a contender in the East. You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game.
Buries the long-range jumper. Lopez has got 5 points in the quarter.
You simply have to remember that Brook Lopez can stroke the jumper. This guy on catch and shoot is terrific.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Kicks it to Korver. Pass to Connaughton to the paint and stolen by Williams. Outside, Walker. Off target from outside.
I'll tell you, it's been a struggle for him in this period, and they're struggling as a result.
Hill, no good. And so it's Williams who brings it up for the Boston Celtics. It's a 13-point game. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. That'll be the latter half of this two-game homestand.
The clever floater, right? Marcus Smart putting the right amount of touch on what is really a tough shot.
Bucks passing it around. Here's Giannis. That one, no good. Now the Celtics take it the other way. They're getting their first look of the season at the Bucks in this one.
Yeah, plenty of familiarity in this matchup. Last season, they were knocked out of the playoffs by this club. It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Boy, Kev, he's known Korver as a knockdown shooter, but what a pretty pass.
Now, here's Tatum. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. Walker's got his 5th assist in this one. And here's Hill. Wow! Unbelievable!
Can't do it much better than that right before the clock expires.
What a way to seize momentum. Can it carry over into the next quarter? Beautifully done.
And so it's Milwaukee, sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. They've got their field goal percentage to thank for that. They've been hot from all over the floor tonight. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Chris, you guys were able to get the lead. What was the key to getting all those open shots?
It was just getting stops, getting rebounds, getting out of pushing, finding lanes, finding open guys.
And you made the most of it, Chris. Thanks a lot. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. So far, a pretty lopsided game, but still one half to play. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. A tremendous game we're seeing from Giannis Antetokounmpo. He ended up with 26 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 steals. When does this guy cool off? I mean, he's been stringing together multiple monster games lately. Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks' first half?
Well, it comes down to confidence. From the opening tip, these guys had that swag. They had the attitude that if you can't beat us, we can only beat ourselves.
And Shaq, what are your thoughts on Boston?
Well, they gave up too many good looks. You look at the field goal percentage against them, this tells the whole story. Not enough activity defensively, not enough disruption, right? Like, can he disrupt me all the time? Not enough disruption.
Bad.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. You look at Antetokounmpo in this one. He's been everywhere.
And the way he goes at defenders, he is bound to get to the line just like he did there in that first half.
I have to love his tenacity. This guy stays in attack mode, makes defenders work, tries to keep them off balance.
Tatum and Hayward make up the two forward spots. Walker and Smart, the guard. And it's Cantor in at the five spot. That's the group for Brad Stevens. Getting going here in the second half. Celtics trail by 14. Moves on moves. That's Jason Tatum.
I mean, this guy is a natural isolation scorer. Jab steps, crossovers, turnarounds, fadeaways. He's got an awful lot in his bag.
And they double up Giannis. Back to Bledsoe. Beyond the arc. A three-pointer is right on target. Bledsoe's got 5 now.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
Walker against Bledsoe. The shot by Hayward, wide open, and he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
Middleton on the wing, guarded by Smart. Shots good by Middleton.
And even with the big lead, he remains focused on the task at hand.
That is the competitiveness he brings to the table. Every night you're going to get great effort from him.
Count the basket.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
And Giannis throws it down.
Well, just an easy hoop all set up by the passing instincts of Eric Bledsoe.
Celtics trail by 17. There's the pass to Smart to the inside. And slam dunk by Tatum.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. To be young again.
Makes you nostalgic, doesn't it? Bucks have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Bledsoe finds Lopez. It's Antetokounmpo on the wing. Bledsoe against Cantor. Lock at 6. Kicks it out to Giannis. Fires from the wing. And another basket for Milwaukee.
Well, you love that they've been able to rely on him time and time again. You love the effort here late.
And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That will get him his 4th foul of the game. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Outside, Smart. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.